Still tries to do that sometimes, even from the mid lane, even though he's been gone for so long.
That was the talk between those two that really rekindled the fire we have right now of CLG. We'll see what Link decides to do. Elise has been played three times here on his side.
Yeah, Elise, an extremely common first pick, especially with how much CLG likes to play the turret game recently. I haven't seen them do exceptionally well with Elise. But at the same time, it is Nintendo Dex's most favorite jungle. I'd actually think Nintendo might default back to Olaf now that Elise has been taken away from him. It'll also be able to match with some of the wave clear.
No.
But it won't be able to match with the early turret pushing. And they don't have to pick it right away because CLG's already picked their jungle.
Yeah. Looking for what he can get. He's brought the Shyvana out. It didn't go too well for Nintendo before. He has a win and a loss on it. And a win and a loss on Olaf, which is already banned out. So the Renekton is picked up, though. It gives Zion Spartan something to work with this game.
Yeah, Zion Spartan will look to bully Nien. Nien hasn't been able to really have an impact in any of these games. And it's hardest to have an impact against a laner like Renekton. He does nothing but generally keep people down. I like those picks, though.
They take Shyvana away as well. Mm-hmm.
So I like that in the sense that there was a fairly low chance Nintendo would play Shyvana in the jungle against an Elise because the early game ganking is just too mismatched. And then also, even though Shyvana was very lightly nerfed in the 4.1 patch, in the patch before that, the Shyvana versus Renekton matchup was often in favor of Shyvana. She will lose for the first 8 or 9 levels and then start turning it back around with damage and pushing. And that's really all that Nien has to be able to do against Zion Spartan is neutralize him and then scale better into the late game. Just because Coast relies so much on playing a very solo lane focused game. So if he can control Zion Spartan, then it's on the rest of the team to control Shifter and they should be good.
Well, it looks like Nintendo Dex wants to have a little bit of say on the control over those lanes as well.
Yeah.
He goes with his second Wukong pickup.
The Monkey King, he had a pretty solid game on it when they played Cloud9. Some of the team fights went against them near the end, but definitely in the mid game, he helped transition Coast out of what was a weak laning phase in that game to be quite strong. In this matchup, though, Nintendo's backing up much stronger laners. Renekton, Caitlyn, Leona in the top lane and the bottom lane, respectively, or if they decide to swap even, are almost top of class as far as lane strength goes. So it'll actually give him a lot more freedom with what he wants to do in the jungle.
That Wukong gang was really the story of a few missed ults that allowed the game to really scale
and
in the way
really
of the opponents.
And some really slick moves by Lemon Nation.
Absolutely. Looking at what's going on, this was banned out before and the crowd booed. Now they get to see it again.
Everybody just wants to see Doublelift on Vayne. That's what they come here for. That's what I tune into CLG games for oftentimes. Although, he needs a long time to be able to really hit his stride on Vayne. They have Ziggs in the mid lane too to try and keep up with the wave push that they might have to deal with if Caitlyn decides to start taking as many turrets as possible. We'll get back to that composition in a minute, but we got to focus on Coast's last pick here.
Is there synergy that's coming in with this team composition overall for a Siege or a Poke?
For Coast?
What they're trying to put together?
At the moment, Coast just has extremely strong laning, and they're going to hope to synchronize, I think, Wukong hitting that strong mid game with Renekton so that those two can initiate and then Katarina can come in for a cleanup.
Third time's a charm.
Third time's a charm for Shifter.
Wow.
He's played Katarina twice. He's really pretty much the sole person who's playing Katarina in the North American LCS. It fits with Coast's roaming style from the mid lane. He prefers to do this on LeBlanc or Kassadin, but they're always banned. So he's kind of just playing third in class as far as him wanting to roam down on that Katarina. It has not worked yet, as we've said. He's had some weak laning phases, some decent rotations in the mid-game, but no victories.
All right. Well, while the teams load into the game, let's take a look at who you think is going to walk away with the win. According to LOLESports.com, 77% of you think that CLG will end their weekend with a victory.
We also had an 80% vote for CLG earlier in their game against Vulcan. And CLG will want to walk away from this weekend with 2-1 kind of at the worst. Now, although they had three games on the weekend, if we look at their strength of schedule, I think they played three of the four bottom teams in the standings coming into this. So they definitely should be succeeding in these games if they want to show themselves as a top team here in North America, or at least to be considered in the sentences.
Well, they're definitely already warmed up from the previous two. We'll have to see if they can get game three with a bit better of a result. They're able to find a win within one of these. What CounterLogic Gaming with Chouster? Obviously undefeated right now. He's coming in big in the mid lane. We'll see if they can keep it.
Yeah, and the first thing I'm going to want to watch for in this game is if we see any lane swaps off the bat.
Yeah, you see that with Vayne.
COD's coach Monte Cristo was incredibly vocal about saying how with the turret changes in the 4.1 patch that everything would be about the bottom turret, and if you sent, you know, it was just going to be two or three people down there every time. But then COG themselves in one game did end up sending two people to the top lane. I wonder if Doublelift is confident in laning against the Caitlyn Leona, or if Coast themselves just want to switch it up and try and trade some turrets early to accelerate the game into a bit of a mid-game.
I am pretty excited to see what Vayne can do and where it will go as well. It looks like they're heading towards the bottom side of the map for just right now. Nothing unorthodox in the inventories. We do see Zion Spartan, however, going for more damage as opposed to the shield start in that top lane.
Yeah, Zion going with the Doran's Blade on Renekton. Really going to be trying to take control of Nien early, as Renekton will do, and then
as
try to avoid getting punished by Lynx Elise.
Shake it.
Daydream and dance. It's a pool party in the bush. I don't think that's a pool party, Leona. I think that's a normal Leona. Can't tell.
I'm pretty sure.
Can't tell in the brush there.
Well, we got a pool party Ziggs. Somebody's got to lock in the pool party team one time. Nobody's playing Graves, but it works from top to bottom. It is all there. You got your Renekton, your Lee Sin, Ziggs, Graves, Leona. Boom. It works right now, too.
Right there.
Somebody needs the courage.
So what he could be doing is he could be warding if he wouldn't have started with the Doran Shield. I'm a little surprised here. Daydreamin went straight for Doran Shield instead of for a Relic Shield.
Oh, Nien. There's not much crowd control to be had here.
Yeah,
so
that's about all that's going to happen.
Kind of a walkout.
Oh,
the little more is going to happen now when you bring the spider into the mix, and it's going to be Zion Spartan. You can see that start look to be on the volatile spider Link, so Link won't be able to get in for the execution.
Well, now, I wonder if Zion Spartan is going to go back to base or whether he's just going to try and farm up in the lane with him being so low on health. He would lose so much experience if he had to go back. It might end up being a somewhat disastrous start for Zion Spartan just because he poked his head in too far.
Get those auto attacks in.
Yeah. Nien
getting a few more. So Zion Spartan's forced to play very careful here. Like we said, he started with the Dorans, so he's not getting any stop on those auto attacks.
Yeah, he needs to auto attack full stop to get health up with his Doran's Blade. Unlike Nien, who started with the Doran Shield and can regen. Likewise, Link on Elise is much better at sustaining than intended in the jungle. So early stuff going for CLGs.
Daydreamin wants control of that bush again, but there's no shield stun after the Xena.
Yeah, exactly. We're just like, is he going to? Oh, wait, he's level one. So he can really just only go in. He was trying to get just a little bit of health on Aframu. CLG has been playing these 2v2 lanes incredibly aggressive all weekend long. They are daring people to fight them 2v2 because they have so much confidence in their own mechanics. You can also see with the exhaust on Aframu, it's a little bit of just trying to bait people into fights and then turning them around, which CLG has done actually quite successfully in both of their games thus far.
Aframu was picking up a few kills in the earlier games. We see him starting with the Doran Shield instead of the Ring, as he usually does. But he's going to get beat up in that lane a little bit. We see in the top lane again, not your normal tank lane. These guys are definitely going head-to-head, thinking one can take out the other.
Yeah, well, it's a fantastic start for Nien, because normally Renekton just bullies the crap out of Siobhan at this point. But because he took so much early damage, he can't get that edge.
Oh, he gets the tumble on! Level 2 is there, but Aframu in a very good position with that stun up.
Just getting a little bit of harass. The minion wave was too large for Daydreamin to go in, and Leona really hits her strongest point in the lane at level 3 once she has her own shield.
Shouster combo on the Shifter, not allowing him to do too much. You see Shifter is keeping his distance and trying to farm with those blades in the mid lane. 4 minutes in, Nien pushed back to that 75% mark just past the river. He's going to be happy to be farming right there. Doesn't need any help from the jungler. That really gives Link anything to do now.
Can see, I really like Link's jungle Gragas pick earlier. Even though they didn't come out victorious,
right,
it was a champion that he is obviously going to be very comfortable on, since he is a mid laner by trade and just happened to be in the jungle. Elise is not necessarily one of those junglers, you know. It's the thing that he probably has played a lot of since picking up the role. But whenever a really, really high pressure situation comes up, I don't know how well he's going to be able to perform, just because that's not a role he has been playing and has the experience in.
Elise.
Or champion, rather.
Right. Elise, very mechanically, like a highly rated player. It's not the easiest one to just pick up. He's going to try to do what he can here on the backside of Nien. Zion Spartan has the minion wave, and they're trying to think they can kind of bait out the fight with that.
Now, well, Zion has regained at least a bit of power in the lane. He's been able to heal up with his Q. Empowered Q gives him increased healing. But the wave's actually in a really bad spot for Zion Spartan right now. He wants to farm. He is open to a gank. It's a very hard gank to pull off here. Link does have a red buff, but without landing his stun, he pretty much has nothing left since Zion Spartan has E and Slice and Dice.
Can he get that Slice and Dice to go through Nien? He may be stuck here in the lane. He gets the one slice and the dice that repels into the bush with the ward on it, and it looks like they're going to be able to take Zion here. No, Nintendo Dex coming out of the fog of war. It's less than 100 HP on the Zion Spartan. A first blood, and it does come in from the Rome of Nintendo.
And a little bit of action down the bot lane. Let's see how aggressive they end up getting.
Very good kills to the top, and it looks like everybody wants a piece now. Doublelift and Aphromoo back off half health.
All right, so that top lane escape right there. Nintendo's level 5. He has a lot of damage.
It's going to be a big hit here. One more. Does he have the flash up? It is down.
He's waiting for his E cooldown, though, and again, would have to flash because he could chase him down. So, Coast's top lane combo. We can't talk about this.
Never mind. We're still going in daydreaming. Not much mana there, so that was an all or nothing. They say it's nothing.
Come on, Coast. Everybody calm down here. We've got Zion Spartan and Nintendo Dex. We're going to talk about this. No, Shifter's coming down.
Yeah.
Here we go.
It's a Link.
They're rather low. Nice ward over the wall.
Did he see the ward, or is he checking down to the bottom lane?
He must have seen that ward.
Maybe not. He still is going to force his way onto this. Link is just on the other side. It's the Flash and the Shun Po to get in here. The Ignite goes down. Doublelift gets the kill, but Wiz Fusion picks it up. They're still trying to pressure behind the turret. CLG
Six
is
bomb.
In the good spot. Oh, the bomb comes in. Big damage. Wiz Fusion just a few more hits, and it's a volatile spider. Shifter, he's going to go down. A great roam from Chouster to answer.
So it's really all about that knowledge from CLG when they put the ward to predict the roam. You can see Link is waiting in the wings to kind of bait this one in, and Doublelift, even though he does get caught, it sets up better action for the rest of the team. Aphromoo knew Shifter was coming, saved the exhaust for him, was able to neutralize the damage he could put out afterwards, and then at this point, it was really just all about keeping chase from Link. Aphromoo can't participate because he's out of mana. They're just waiting for Chouster's Ziggs to come. A lot of communication and coordination from CLG.
Cyclone onto Chouster. This actually looks like it could be very bad, Jat. He puts the ducky down, gets himself in turret range. He's safe.
Really calm, too.
Yeah.
If you notice, Chouster has barrier and flash still available, so a lot of cooldowns expended there by Nintendo for only health on the other side.
Nien is not liking this. He has Dragon's Descent to get away, and that won't be the chase from Zion Spartan. His Ignite's down, so is Nien's. They've been fighting it out in this top lane. Usually we don't even go up there for 20 minutes. We've been there since the start.
Yeah, and there was a very nice bait that Zion Spartan pulled up there when he was able to run away properly, and it did end up giving Nintendo Dex one kill. Now we need to see how Nintendo transitions that. One of the big reasons Jungle Wukong is seeing a huge surge in play was the recent buff slash changes to the Spirit of the Other Lizard item, where it gives him health and mana back in the jungle. It's such a great item for Wukong because he's got a ridiculous AD ratio, total AD ratio on his kit, and now he's able to heal up in the jungle off of that item. And the fact that he got the kill means he should get the item faster and could very well transition some good power into it.
Wukong's all about getting to the lane, trying to help out your teammates, and that's where Nintendo usually is. We've seen him right in the back of Shifter, right on the back of Zion Spartan, and the kill potential for those lanes is quite big. We're also talking about Link on Elise and how it may not play into his style of being that mid laner, not so much a jungler, but early kills for him, get him started nice. Yep. He starts with the Sorc Boots.
Transitioning on Elise is actually one of the harder things to do as far as junglers go. Just based on the fact that she is a shapeshifter with her kit and has really six normal abilities and no true ultimate, makes her team fighting much different than with other champions. Other champions are relying, kind of working and comboing her spells to get that one ultimate, whereas Elise is very single target focused and has to cycle and be very smart about things. But that's great in skirmishes, harder to do in team fights, and it takes an expert player to be able to get good efficiency out of Elise in team fights.
Nintendo Dex has a pinpoint right now onto Link. They're just trying to keep that away. Dragon's Descent in the top lane. Looks like Zion Spartan is safe there, yep.
Sound Spartan must have expected some kind of gank. There's very low ward coverage for Coast on the map right now. It's just how top lane works.
It's ultimate for ultimate. Oh, going in onto Link. He's going to have the rappel after this, but he really can't go anywhere except for in Dragon Pit. He doesn't want to be there. It's going to be the pinch, and no! He gets out to the side, and beautiful job, double him with the block, but will he get himself killed? Link's there for the cocoon and the volatile spider. What a beautiful play.
I would have to say a wasted Leona ult from Daydreamin', but it does not make the escape any more spectacular looking right there. Link got caught up position. They burn another Nintendo Dex Wukong ultimate, and they get mid lane turret pressure out of it because Shifter roamed down.
Very nice job by Chouster to keep his eye on that mid lane while knowing what's going on around him, not wasting any time trying to roam or participate in something that won't be there when he arrives. 10.5 minutes into this game, CLG seems to have their heads on very straight, but Coast isn't really giving up too much either. These guys are neck and neck.
Yeah, I would say that Coast has actually had more opportunities to take a lead, but have missed on those opportunities, whereas CLG has converted most of their opportunities for success right here. And that's pretty much all from the bottom lane and that last avoidance we saw from CLG in the bottom lane. Now they're going to try and take some of this ward advantage they had accumulated earlier and turn it into something. I think CLG should try and control a dragon fairly shortly. If Chouster can harass Shifter down in lane, they could peel for that thing, especially knowing that Leona's Solar Flare is down for the next couple seconds.
Could get it, and that next couple seconds is the flash. Tibber's initiation coming in from Aphromu. It's all they needed to take down Daydreamin', but he picks up the kill for himself.
Yeah, Daydreamin' was trying to get ward control back, and CLG punished it. One of the big reasons that Aphromu picks Annie so frequently is the reliable stun so that Doublelift can then follow up and get kills. Doublelift's big transition as an AD carry this season needs to be actually getting kills for his team rather than just farming, and instead of just farming himself, denying the enemy of resources and well. Stuff like Aphromu on Annie can help him do that.
Winning past the lane, not just in CS, but keep going. We're looking at 1,000 gold in favor of CLG from the small back and forth that we have had. Doublelift is going for that Bloodthirster first, I believe, instead of the Blade of the Rune King here, so we'll see how that works for him.
Yeah. And also, aside from items, Shifter's never-ending quest to roam continues.
Yes.
He was just up in the top lane, could not find a rotation there. And now his turret is almost down because Chouster's been chipping away at it the entire game. So much of Shifter's playstyle is predicated around solo queue, where there's less coordination and his roaming is incredibly successful. It has not yet transitioned into LCS play.
One thing you need coming in is that team communication. Tries to knock him back into the turret, but Zion Spartan finds his way out. It looks like Dragon could go to Coast on this one. There will be no contest.
Even though it would have been a 4v4, that was a smart time for Coast to go down to Dragon. Fight up top.
And it looks like Nien, the Ignites are down on both sides. He tries to steal back the health of Cole the Beak, but the Ignite is there to tick away.
And look at the item differential that was apparent right there. That was just basically a Doran's Blade and a pickaxe on Zion Spartan, and a full Giant's Belt, Doran's, and Boots onto Nien. He was just stronger for that particular engagement, while Zion Spartan's champion would have been stronger at that point. Yeah. The itemization gave Nien the edge, and now that they've hit that level 10 point and taken a kill, Nien should actually start taking control.
A little bit of HP giving him the upper hand. Like you said, he should be able to control that in the top lane. That's the skill. Nien has always been able to keep himself on top of his lane up in CS, which it's still a few, but he is there and making the plays he needs to for his team so they don't have to focus him. And we've seen that. Link has been in other lanes, helping other places.
Yeah, oftentimes we don't see the most successful teams lately spend much time in the top lane. Most of them have been ganking for the mid lane, and I'd say recently in the LCS there's been more of a trend of going bot lane more and more. Not entirely sure why that is yet, but it's just a thing we've noticed.
Pink wards and a few regular wards going down as Coast tries to take control of the river and pings as Nintendo Dex creeps up in the shadows.
Yeah, so no real Wukong ganks have came in successfully. He's walking right through a ward. This could actually be a pretty golden opportunity if CLG wanted to set up a counter gank or just waste Coast time. Right here, Doublelift is going to kind of play just out of range of the initiating Nintendo Dex and be ready to disengage as long as he plays this smart. But he's playing with a bit of fire here.
Kind of a scary disengage, like you said, to even play with. Link is still very far behind, and they're going to walk this one up slowly.
Yeah, the ward got tipped off when the minions started attacking Nintendo Dex in the brush. So CLG's game was up, but they did waste a fair bit of time.
Nintendo thinking he's going to get a little bit of attention at his blue buff, but I believe that Link, getting out that pink ward, will decide to hover up to the top side. He warded just past last time. You can see where Coast has warded now, so they're trying to take back their jungle. The sweepers are out for the supports with these side stones now.
Let's take a look at what CLG was trying to do this game as well. Whenever they pick Vayne, Doublelift will always try and get to a point where he can outduel the other AD carry. He's running with Bloodthirster. He's basically there right now if he can catch Wiz Fusion in a 1v1. The ultimate battle continues. And they're done again. So bot lane is... No, it's a strange battle in that lane. Now CLG is trying to push more and more. And really, just because CLG is outscaling, they're in complete control. They actually don't need to make any big risks right now. And it's all on Coast to try and make things happen. Every time Shifter goes to roam, CLG will accumulate a larger advantage. Also, CLG, I also notice against reset champions, are very willing to itemize like a Guardian Angel. I think Doublelift will probably go Guardian Angel after his second offensive item this game, try and stop Shifter from doing work. And since CLG is playing so conservatively in these lanes, Shifter won't get roam in the first place and will not be that big of a threat late game. Most of these things right now are going in favor of CLG if they don't make mistakes.
Poking a hole in the cape of Vayne there on Doublelift. Daydreaming just on the outside of that ward. And it looks like three strong will push down to the bottom lane for Coast. They're going to look to grab this turret. Really, Link out of position for this. And Shifter will have a chance to roam here. The Deathfire Grasp might come into play, but he is walking all over wards.
Yeah, they basically just traded turrets there. CLG lost their bot lane turret because of jungle pressure. CLG gained a top lane turret because they ended up to send Chouster up there since he'd already gotten the mid turret. It's actually been Ziggs who's given them about two turrets based mainly off of Shifter's roam because that's given either Chouster more time in the mid lane or more time to roam up to the top lane.
Gotta give credit to Shifter in the mid lane. Not the easiest to CS against a Ziggs wave pushing you into the turret, but he does, like we said, have that Deathfire Grasp and has found himself a kill. But it's CLG keeping themselves safe and with Link always on the backside.
Yeah, I would say Shifter either needs to make this Katarina work now or start looking for other options because three attempts at this... They're really building this composition completely around him, too, is the other thing. They're trying to load as much initiation in with Leona, Wukong, and Renekton so they can just stay in the fight kind of by themselves and then let Shifter come in late. They're also sacrificing a lot of mid lane map control because Shifter's been running back and forth so much. Obviously, Shifter is trying to help his team because the team is already helping him. And at the moment, Shifter's just not keeping his end of the bargain right now. He needs to be able to find these fights with the rest of his team and get in for the cleanup. I just wonder if he's going to be able to do so.
And it's not going to be any easier when they start grouping. They have multiple things that can knock him out of that Death Lotus, and it's almost conditional for him to wait for those before he can even go in the fights.
Yeah, because Annie could knock it out, Vayne could condemn, Elise could stun, and even if Nien ulted over the top of it, it could be one of those things. The team has to be careful that actually not tunnel vision too hard on the Death Lotus, because it's often a lot of the other spells Katarina throws out that end up being the most lethal, especially if she can get a killer assist. But CLG, if they are just worrying about the Death Lotus, do have plenty of responses.
Looking to get a little bit of that armor shred up as a Black Cleaver being created. The Timber's just missing on the outside there, but they have enough damage going out to Daydreaming. Again, it's the auto attack of Aphromoo to pick up the last hit.
Not the smoothest gank, and this could be some successful Shifter roam. Let's see if we can make it down here in time. Wukong's on the chase as well.
Oh, these guys are going to meet face-to-face in the bush. There's the Deathfire Grass, the Lotus into the Ducky, and it's a great bounce out and stop of the Death Lotus.
So just a one for one in the end of it. And unfortunately, Aphromoo picked up that kill instead of Doublelift. The Dragon is also up as well, but Shifter had blown Chouster low. Let's see what happens here.
Looks like they are back and forth. Cat and mouse over. The barrier goes down with the Cyclone, fully hitting two members. Nintendude just gets obliterated. You can see him grabbing his hair. What happened there?
That was one of those situations where Nintendude saw a good play for himself that was a bad play for the team. The team wanted to do the Dragon. No one could support him over the wall. And even though he could nearly solo Chouster, there were too many people there. That's one of those situations where he'll say, oh, if their team wasn't there, it would have been great. The problem is the team was there, and there was no way for his own team to support him.
Getting ahead of himself a little bit. Looks like Zion Spartan trying to harass Nien, but that's just going to pressure him back to the top lane, and nobody's there to stop Nien right now. He's pretty much controlling that side of the jungle.
Yeah, and this really hurts Coast as well, the fact that Nintendo used his flash and his ultimate in that last engagement. Because these are the items that Nintendo Dex wanted for when Coast would take control of the game. This is when his ultimate is generally most lethal in the game. He has armor penetration, the enemy generally doesn't have armor at this point, and he has most of his attack damage that he's going to be getting in the game. So he is incredibly threatening if he can get his ultimate off, and he can't.
One of these real reasons why, kind of thinking to myself, I'm not giving CLG the full lead. That Cyclone on top of Zion Spartan, Daydreaming at that Dragon Pit is such a good fight. But without being in position, without getting the game in their favor up to here, they're hard struck for anything like that.
Yeah, this was actually a tremendous swing in the game for CLG's favor. They are, I think, absolutely in control right now and need to just continue this. It was very close and contentious if Coast would have been able to actually fight at that dragon. Doublelift will continue to farm. At this point, Chouster is getting stronger and stronger to be able to burst down Shifter in teamfights because he's not going to be able to withstand too much damage. Mm-hmm. And also, Nien is basically outscaling Zion Spartan at this point. I'd say Zion Spartan has about another 10 minutes to make a decent impact in team fights, and after that, I feel like he's just going to be meat for Doublelift to chop through.
See if they can get him down to that reset-esque portion of life. Shifter has been known to... They were around 3,000, 4,000 gold the last time we saw him playing Katarina, and it still was a great team fight for them. They know how to utilize it, but they don't get it on their terms at all, and it's exactly what they need right now.
Well, I would actually say... 2 games ago when he played Katarina against TSM, it was very successful. And when he played it against Cloud9, the team fights were completely shut down.
That's true.
Yeah, the Cloud9 team did a much better job keeping him. So he's kind of had one good team fight game and one bad team fight game. One good early game, one bad early game. Such is the life of Coast. They can't put everything together into one game to find victory.
Seeing Nien piecing together the Cutlass. Little Negatron cloak there, as well as the Sunfire cape to keep that split push going. Him and Zion have just been going back and forth the whole game.
Yeah, there's been a pretty good battle up there. And Yen's definitely come out on top. Higher CS, been able to kill him. Had to deal with the early assist that Zion Spartan picked up as well. And Shyvana is the champion that outscales. At this point, it's about whether Nien can be a big factor for his team. It's very infrequently do we notice a game where Nien has a huge impact on. This could be his chance.
You know, same for Coast. Recently, we talk about them having an impact, coming together as a team, and it's really something we saw when they picked Daydreaming up, but it's been lackluster since then, and I don't know what they need to do to find that. Shifter's been trying to go outside the box. Everything they try just kind of comes back at them.
Well, it is a long season as well. Mm-hmm. They were so successful in the offseason. They dominated all of the NACL Challenger Leagues that were out there. So they had a lot of confidence built up. And I think it's really just they got so used to beating up on that level of competition that when they try to transition this strategy to the LCS, it just hasn't worked out too well. It's kind of like running zone defense in a college basketball game, if anyone gets that reference. It doesn't work nearly as well in the pros because people are way better shooters, and you leave people open, they'll end up making shots.
Absolutely.
Here, Coast relied in the Challenger Series around roaming and taking advantage of positioning in the mid-game. But LCS teams, especially someone like CLG, are much better at controlling lanes, keeping up wards, and avoiding ganks.
You know, since we saw the CLG Curse game, it kind of wowed us with where did this rotation come from CLG? Where did this communication come from? They won the game with nearly getting zero kills because their movement was so good. 36,000 gold. 32,000 gold. Coast is looking to make up that 4,000, hopefully in a few of these turrets. They've only dropped the bottom turret. The mid one would open up the map quite nicely to at least get in the hair of CLG, because right now everything is in defense.
Yeah, and we can see a little bit of paranoia on CLG as well to deal with that Katarina roam. There's 4 wards in the red side jungle and about 7 in the blue side jungle. And it's just meaning that Coast doesn't have any actual approaches to initiate on CLG.
Still got to give it respect. He will come in and make your day a living hell. Link getting warded out. I'm going to try to take that one out. But he knows he can't. Well, maybe he can. No, his sweeper's down. So we'll see what they... Oh, Doublelift a little too close. Yep, that's enough
of
that. Too
close to the sun right there. They might continue this chase. There is a flash on Intended if he wants to find something.
Stun is up. They actually walk right into the bush without being able to see it. They try to get onto Link. A good flash over the wall. Looks like they will be able to capitalize on another kill. Does not have much of anywhere to go after this. And that goes to Shifter. They're starting to make what they need to have happen. Looks like he lays down the minefield in the top side, but Zion Spartan has already passed to safety.
Well, Chouster roamed up to the top, and honestly, that was just Daydreamin' making a play. He landed the Zenith Blade on a doublelift, and they just blew him up. You can just notice he got in a bit of a fight with his fusion, but the team wasn't there for support. Daydreamin' saw an opportunity, and it was pretty much all Leona. His fusion just got the ace in the hole to finish there. Obviously, the chase at the end was able to clean up as well. Shifter doing his textbook roam down to try and become involved. Daydreamin flashes, secures the kill.
And the mentality of Coast may be changing a little bit.
Hey, that's a big play. That's actually a really big play. They got another kill on a Shifter, allowed him to finish his Void Staff. You can already see Doublelift going towards some defensive itemization. I thought maybe he'd go GA, but since he's sitting on a health crystal, it's more likely going to be a Spectre's Cowl into a Banshee's Veil, which will hopefully block some of the upfront burst from Shifter, and maybe even prevent Leona from landing a long-range ultimate stun, since he is running Cleanseless. Doublelift used to almost always go for Cleanse. There's no Mikhail's Crucible either on Aphromoo, so it's very important that he has some spell block.
They have to be careful, as we didn't see, but during the replay, Coast was able to drop the middle turret of Counter Logic Gaming. This helps so many various aspects. If Baron comes up, we're 26 minutes in, there's spots to go. They're doing well.
Yeah, and the next dragon is the next chance for Coast to try and take control back in this game. This time, they have Nintendo DX's ultimate up, and a Black Cleaver finished. Very, very important. Watch to see if Nintendo DX can initiate on the right target or if they decide to fight. There is a flank happening from CLG.
The Rabadon's is finished. The bomb is up. The flank won't happen, Jad. They take that down quickly and decisively.
Yeah, CLG did not want to mess with them in that fight. There was a lot of danger for disaster, and CLG would rather give up the 1,200 gold, seeing as they were split up on two sides of the fight, and Coast could have very easily picked one side and just steamrolled it because they have such substantial initiation. Overall, I'd say it's a smart move by CLG to not fight.
Given Shifter, any more kills could be pretty detrimental to how this game is about to go. So far, the pacing is even. It is 3-2 in turrets. Gold is even, however, and those kills, right back to back. Blade of the Rune King finished up onto Nien. A little more 1v1 duelist-ish now versus Zion Spartan.
Yeah, and we see how the gold is about 2,000 away. But I wonder how much of that is actually in the items. Since when we generally have been looking at the minimap throughout this game, it's been littered with CLG wards. How many of those wards are now gone and just are lost money, sunk cost for CLG, so to speak? I feel like the itemization in this game is pretty much bang even.
No, that's a very good point. Nintendo DX still needs to do that damage, but he's finally getting a little bit of mitigation in there. Oh, Zion Spartan in the end. Nien's not really giving any respect right now. He's saying, my team is going to dictate what's happening in mid, so I can roam up here.
Yeah, Zion Spartan's struggling. As long as he can keep tabs on Nien and never be stuck top lane while Nien fights, he can kind of survive. But that is a lost battle for Coast. Nien trying to make a play mid lane because he rotated down sooner.
This is much better a game for Nien. He's already has two games on Shyvana, which came out as losses. This is definitely changing things around for him. Top lane is pushed in. He can still control that. This top half of the map, he hasn't even really left. He's calling it home right now. The other half of the team in the bottom side, he again doing what he needs to keep the chaos.
Let's think about these late game team fights a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's going to depend very heavily, actually, on Nintendo DX for Coast, whether he lands a good Wukong ultimate. If he does, him and Zion Spartan should be able to get someone low enough that Shifter can get a reset, you know? On the other side for CLG, a lot of it is actually on Nien. You wouldn't think of it like that, but if he can keep Shifter and Wiz Fusion back, much like Balls did on Renekton in their game of shutting down, a very similar Coast composition, that's basically what they need to do. And, I mean, if they can keep that back, I think Doublelift will be fine at dealing with Nintendo and Zion Spartan. So, a couple key players on either side of these teamfights. The scaling itself is a little bit in favor of CLG, as it always is, but not by much.
Animalistic instincts kicking in here between these two. They're a little hungry for dinner. Neither are going to get the kill. They back off. Hungry stomach still in the top lane, but the turret in favor of Nien. Big damage. Aphromoo tries to get himself to safety. This is Doublelift trying to go crazy. The Mega Inferno Ball comes in, and it's going to be enough for a kill.
Zigzalt definitely turning that one. Ace in the hole is blocked.
Nice catch.
That was a good catch. And they're still trying to force a little bit, but they can't deal with the overall pressure of CLG. Nien was able to take the mid lane afterwards, Riv.
Nien is covering two lanes by himself right now. Top when he wants and mid when he can.
It's because Zion can't necessarily deal with him. That was a nice fight by CLG. Just winning a mechanical duel, I'd have to say. Yes, Doublelift is a bit stronger in duels into his fusion, but it's a tricky one. Nintendo still wanting an initiation.
They got the wards there. A very nice Cyclone. Doublelift goes down. That's the main DPS here. If Chouster goes down too, they may be up the creek without a paddle. But Coast doesn't want any more right now.
Well, that's Coast striking back. It did cost them, though, both of their flashes on the two main chasers. So Shifter and Nintendo are much less lethal for the upcoming fights. And that's how this is going to go, I feel like. One team's going to swing, the other team's going to swing back right here.
CLG has been taunting Coast in the bottom lane. There really haven't been any engagements from CLG. They're still playing their rotation game. We've only been seeing Doublelift engage on, and they finally got one that worked after, what, three times?
Ooh, I wonder, though. This is the big moment. Coast trying to do Baron with five. All five are alive, but they are down most combat summoners. Link and Nien are alive. They want to stop this. There's no smite, actually, on Link right now. He needs a few seconds before that's up, about 12 seconds before he can do this. It might be up by the time they steal it. This is super interesting, Riv.
Wiz Fusion on the backside. He actually gets bumped, so they miss some DPS. Link is there. He gets hit up by Zion Spartan. So much damage or health on the Baron still, that's not going to be smiteable. A good kill coming in a Shifter. They shut down Wiz Fusion. There goes Link, but they're going to be trading back and forth.
Doublelift is on the way.
Focus now down onto Zion Spartan. He is quite tanky, and this is just going to be a chase. They come in on the backside. Will they be able to steal off the Baron? Doublelift trying to shoot over the wall, and he's taking damage as well from this.
Nintendo
tries to keep himself in a good spot to get back in. There's not enough health taken off the Baron yet for the smite. Doublelift double kill. The Mega Inferno Bomb helping Afro Moon pick up the ace. And the Baron going over to counter Logic Dave.
And just like that, CLG has more control over the game. It was a force by Coast. This is a stretch. It is a 3v5, but they're in the Baron pit and so low. Shifter gets obliterated by Nien and Afro. That is the turning tide of the fight, because at that point, Coast is out of damage to try and clear this. They had burned all of their ultimates previously to get the first two kills that made them think they could start this Baron. They were too slow finishing it off, and then by the time CLG was back here, they could just finish it off. You could see Doublelift trying to snipe over the wall, gets a little bit of damage down, but it was actually Afro once again with the flashover that could secure the rest of this for CLG. It was well played by CLG, but only because Coast took such a huge risk to put themselves in such a dangerous situation.
And they were coming back so well. That fight in the bottom lane, it was almost the just about evener to CLG. They definitely didn't have what it needed to take that Baron. They tried it anyways. Sometimes everybody going for that call might make it a good one. However, this is not one of those times. 13-8. We're seeing a 7,000 gold lead racked up now by CounterLogic Gaming. The Dragons, they can still help. There's still gold that's going to come out of them in the late game, and Coast base is still pretty healthy.
It still hasn't been cracked, but Riv, how many Coast games
are
we going to have where they seem like they're in it, and then they just seem to lose it in these random fights? Oh, Chouster stole it with a bouncing ball. But how many times is this going to happen for Coast? They just keep losing at around 30 minutes. They stay in the game. Even if they lose the early game, they'll come back. And they'll make a poor decision. It's just again and again. It's got to be heartbreaking for these guys.
They do what they can, putting Shifter on champions that can absolutely carry. But if he doesn't, it's hesitation for the whole team, and it almost shuts down everything.
The strange thing is, while Katarina can carry from the scoreboard, I don't know how well Katarina carries games. She's not a teamfight starter. She's a teamfight finisher.
Yeah.
And especially like in that last fight, Shifter was not in a finishing position. He got initiated on right at the start and taken out. And that's frankly just can't happen for Curse, for Coast.
Right. Well, fights in general causing Coast to have to be in weird spots. See Wiz Fusion getting caught out at the Baron pit during their fight as he was forced to net into the battle just to get in range, which means Doublelift, Aftermoon, all those DPSers are positioning very well. We'll see what they can do now as they might be able to crack the base open coming in at 34 minutes.
A couple big items completed as well. Chouster, Deathcap, Doublelift, Last Whisper, so he can slice through Zion Spartan. Also, Banner of Command, a very unlikely item you could see on Aftermoon. strengthens up those minions, gives him some more. There's a nice ult. Oh, a little too close to the sun, like you see, Jad. Doublelift gets out, though. Nintendo taking a lot of damage with the Cyclone hit fully. They are going to be on Nien right now, and so is the turret. He goes down. They trade two for one so far, and that's going to be Nintendo following Daydreams in the end. Doublelift doing his Doublelift does on Vayne, and he is going to double kill once again.
Yeah, everything went CLG's way on that last effort initiation by Coast. Once again, Shifter was the first to die for Coast, so there was no reset threat coming in for CLG. They could pile through. They still have the Baron buff. Only one defender for Coast Rib. I think CLG takes this one.
CLG looks to take it and make it 2-1 on the week, a three-game week, a heavy weight on their shoulders. Taking off now, the Nexus turret, the second one goes down 35 minutes into the game. They're looking to get a few more kills as Link approaches the fountain to take the laser, and they take the win. Counter Logic Gaming with a victory.
Only took them 35 minutes, Riv, and that was one of their better wins. They played mostly controlled the entire game. Even though Coast had a few attempted initiations onto them, CLG was always there with a response. The one fight they lost ended up turning into the best moment of the game for CLG because it forced Coast into that Baron pit, and then CLG can come and counterattack. Two Vayne wins for Doublelift this weekend as well. He's back on track.
The stark differences between these teams is when CLG knew they were ahead, they did the right thing, and they pretty much just inhaled the base and lanes of Coast. We saw Coast think they were ahead, and they went for Baron and threw it all away.
Yeah, well, one thing we also have to mention here, Nien on Siobhan called him out a little bit before the game, saying he had one of the lowest KDAs and most deaths of top laners. 3-1-7 against Zion Spartan, who was generally feared by most of the community. So, very strong play by Nien, especially some plays in the Baron pit. The initiation near the end of the game that won the game was his only death. So, in helping the team win, it was a solid game all around, and more carrying from Nien than we used to seeing. He has been able to win the lane in the past, but he hasn't been able to transition.
And
this was a transition.
Yep, that was two losses, like you said. Now, the one win on Siobhan because of that turnaround, such a great game for him, putting himself in the carry position like we used to see Nien back in the last splits. Something we have to question, the third pick coming in on Katarina for Shifter.
Yeah.
We got to get an interview with these guys at some time next week and see what is going on with that.
Yeah, well, as far as Coast goes, it is how they play.
Yeah.
So it is very hard for them to move out of this type of position.
It's gonna
stick. And it's not like it is failing or falling flat on its face. It has
been
close to working for them. You know, even when his roams don't warrant kills, you can see the mental stress it puts on the other team. How many wards did